Rocks to entering place.
When NASA loses the Space Shuttle Columbia.
Not a week goes by that I don't dream of my friends that were on that mission. That never leaves you.
The investigation begins immediately.
There are hundreds of theories about what it could have been, from cosmic lightning or mega lightning to extraterrestrials to enemy action.
And an incredible photograph seems to suggest something strange happened to the shuttle.
To me, it looked like a credible photograph and was worth taking another look at by NASA.
February the 1st, 2003. After a 16-day scientific research mission, STS-107 re-enters Earth's atmosphere.
Done so far, fly. We have good trims.
The voice of Flight Commander Rick Husband cuts off mid-transmission.
No onboard system config changes right before we lost data.
That's correct, flight. All look good.
Columbia, Houston, comm check. Columbia, Houston, UHF comm check.
I was working in mission control that fateful morning when Columbia broke up during reentry. And the fact that they disintegrated basically before our very eyes and there was nothing we could do was a very devastating event for all of us in mission control.
Investigating the disaster immediately becomes NASA's top priority.
NASA's going to work very hard and leave no stone unturned until they're sure they know what caused the accident.
You have to get to the bottom of it, otherwise you can't fly the vehicle again. You need an answer.
In the moments before the tragedy, amateur astronomer Peter Goldie was photographing the re-entry.
February 1st, 2003 was the second time I witnessed a shuttle landing coming over San Francisco. It was quite clear to see. And quite beautiful to see because it makes a long, very bright line across the sky. And of course, you know what you're looking at, so it's a tremendous thing.
Watching from a San Francisco hillside, Goldie has no idea what's about to happen. The first inkling that he has witnessed something unusual comes when he looks over the day's photographs.
I didn't know what to make of it. It looked for all practical purposes to be as if it was a jagged purple bolt of lightning intersecting the path of the shuttle.
At the moment Goldie takes his shot, Columbia is too high for any conventional lightning strike. But it's still a possibility NASA takes seriously.
When rockets leave behind a vapor trail, a lightning strike will come up and chase the rocket up to the base of space. These lightning strikes have 100,000 volts or more and a million amperes. Boy, that's a lot of power. That just it heats the atmosphere 100,000 degrees easily. And when they do so, they cause tremendous flashes of light. Definitely cause instrumentation problems.
For NASA, evidence of an electrical discharge is disturbing enough to call in veteran astronaut Tammy Jernigan to investigate.
I thought it was very important to look at every piece of data that might have bearing on the cause of the accident. A photograph certainly warranted further investigation.
So what did Goldie capture on camera? And did it contribute to the disaster? NASA imaging experts begin by examining Goldie's equipment.
They analyzed the photograph, and the corkscrew phenomenon, I believe, was attributed to some type of vibration.
When the camera's shutter opens for the time exposure, there's a brief jiggle, a zig up and down zigzag.
This minute up and down movement of the camera at the precise moment the picture was taken creates the appearance of the zigzag in what is actually the arrow straight line of the shuttle's trajectory. The timing of the shot as the shuttle breaks up is just a tragic coincidence.
The jiggling just happened to coincide with the moment that they had lost the telemetry.
The discovery of the camera fault rules out the possibility that a lightning bolt brought Columbia down.
Liftoff of Space Shuttle Columbia.
Subsequent NASA investigations reveal critical damage to a thermal protection panel during takeoff.
30 seconds into the flight, the three liquid fuel main engines beginning to throttle back, reducing the stress on the shuttle as it breaks through the sound barrier.
When the shuttle came in for reentry, because the structural integrity of that thermal protection system had been violated, it was not able to stand the thermal and mechanical stresses of reentry and came apart.
Commander Rick Husband, Zilan Ramon, pilot William McCool, Michael Anderson, David Brown.
The loss of Columbia's seven astronauts remains one of NASA's darkest days.